Here you come in and the horses don't even know what to do and where's the jump. Here's the fence, could be a nice ground line fence over, no. Then they turn and they see lots of material, wood everywhere. But the question is, which fence do you want me to jump? This, that, or what? And then you see all of a sudden this really narrow, quite wide fence, which you have to approach in a really show jumping canter. And you must sit up, you must really come with your leg from behind into your hand, a little bit wide, so you really guide the horse with your leg into the jump. Not too fast. So you come from here. Jump fence number 16A, land, then it's going downhill, uphill again, and then we have BC, which is again quite wide, and especially wide because you have the drop down, so you come from down, uphill, and then they see how wide it is. And what do we do if we miss this fence, BC? There must be an alternative. If we look around, if you have a miss there, missing that fence there, then you have to do B there, go all the way around, and jump C over there. And you always, when you walk a course, you don't only dream of the ideal world. You better dream of what happens if. So at A, here's nothing. You have to take A. And what we choose, if you come from here in this direction, the horse will not see the other one right away. The horse sees straw, another wooden thing where he's guessing, is it a fence or not? So my decision is, ride this here at this point, do that turn a little bit further and nearly turn backwards. That in the show jumping canter, the horse is really through, really on the aids, listening to me that I can ride this turn nice and smooth. Come from here, so then he will see already BC and knows, aha, there's the next fence. From here, he has no idea and I would have to turn into it, what is more difficult. So approach it here and then land and directly forward. Downhill, take the momentum uphill and try to ride it in five strides. And enjoy. Okay.